it's very interesting chapter, which is known as manipulating the list. Whatever you do in our everyday life, it's common to add some more data to our existing data, modify some data of our existing data, or remove sometimes existing data. So if our new customer is came, then I need to add the customer data. One customer want to modify some details, maybe his phone number or whatever it is, we should able to modify it. If you want to remove that customer, we should able to remove that. Those all activities are possible inside the list. So here in case salary I have it, three items are there, 1000.5, 2002, something like that. But I want to add here 4000, I am adding it by using one of the method that is known as append. Here append is a method of what object? List object. It adds at last position, it is going to add the item. So this 4000.4, it is added in the last position, it is added. If I want somewhere in middle, I want it. Somewhere in middle, I want it. Then we can use here insert, we can use here insert is a method of list object to add a particular index position. What index position I said here? 1. So that is the reason this is 0, this is 1. One index position only, this is added. These are the two things which are available, append. Second is called as insert. Append is for the last position to add it. Insert is whatever position is specified here, in that index position, it is going to add it. Let us try to do same practically. Okay. So what we are trying to learn? We are trying to learn about manipulating. We are trying to learn in that one we have here. First one we are trying to learn about it. Append or insert we are trying to learn about it. Either we are trying to append or you want to insert, we are trying to learn about it. Suppose I have here A is equal to 3 items I am taking, 10, 20, 30. Can you please add 40 at the last? For that, we are writing here A. Press the tab from the keyboard so that you can see list of methods which are available for the A. List of methods which are available for the A. Now we can see the first one, what is called as? Append. What it is called as? Function. Did you create it or already it is available? Already it is available. Similarly, we have some other things also, clear, copy, insert, a number of things. But at this point of time, we want to use here append, we want to use it. I want to append 40, I want to append. Now you can notice the 40 will be added at the last position, it is added. At the last position, it is added. And I want to show you some more things. If I say ID of A, each and every object backend will have some memory location, some memory location. If I go and try to add one more item, for example, A dot append 50, I'm adding, then I'm also taking here ID of A. Is it memory location is changed or not changed? Memory location is not at all changed. That means what? The same memory location, it is keep on expanding. It's keep on expanding. That's what you need to understand. This is nothing but memory location number that is. Memory location number. If I want to add in between 20 and 30, 15, sorry, 25 I want. Then now I can do it A dot, then we can write here insert, we can write it. Then what is the index position of the what I am looking for? This is 0, this is 1, next is what? 2. So 2 is the index position I want it. 25 is the number what I am looking for. Now you can notice A, 25 is added in the position called as second index position. Still my ID whatever available, is it changed or not changed? Not changed, right? Okay. So let us go and try to do next one, that is called as update. I want to do update. How I can do the update? For example, I have here something called as 10. I want to make that as a 9. How I can do that? How to read 10 first? If I say A of 0, we are able to get the 10, right? Then what you can do is A of 0 is equal to 9, allocate like this. Now you can see A is equal to what we are seeing? 9 we are seeing it. Very easily we can update it. First we need to know how to read that item. Once you know read the item, then you can allocate the numbers, you can allocate it. For example, I written here A, then 0 comma, sorry, 0 is 2 I written. What are getting? 9 and 20 is equal to, I am trying to write here, for example, I am writing 8, I am writing 19, I am writing something like this. Then you can observe A is equal to what you got. That means you can change the even multiple items also, you can change it. In this case, change one item, right? In this case, we are changing how many items? Two items. In my example, two items. But of course, you can go and you can do multiple items also. You can change it. Change multiple items. You can change it. Very easy to change it. That's what it's known as update. Now, if I want to remove certain element, how I can remove it? How I can delete, if I want to delete certain element? For example, I don't love here 19, I don't love it. So I am expecting you to delete that 19. Can you please help me first how to read the 19? How to read the 19? Yeah, one means we are able to read it. If you go and try to add here DEL, delete function, if you are adding, then if you try to delete it, it is deleted. And you can see the A without 19, we are seeing now data. Without 19, we are seeing that previously what is available? 19, now there is no 19. Now still my ID whatever available earlier, is it looking for same or different? That means same memory location, we are playing around it. We are adding, we are updating, we are deleting, whatever you want, we are doing it. That is a specialty of this one. Can you please tell me the English meaning of mutable? Okay, I will practice this one, then we'll see that one in next one. Practice these three things: insert, append, update, delete.